Okay, students, in the last class we were discussing about the differences between absorption and adsorption, right? So here this is the adsorption and absorption difference. So I hope you practice the definitions with the examples for adsorption, desorption and sorption. Okay, so in adsorption, the substance is only retained on the surface and does not go into the bulk or interior of the solid or liquid. So thus, instead of writing this whole sentence, you can just write adsorption is the surface phenomenon. Okay, so adsorption is a surface phenomenon, whereas absorption is the bulk phenomenon. So adsorption is a rapid process and equilibrium is maintained attained in a short time. See, adsorption enagutte andre, it is a rapid process. For example, when you dip a chalk in the ink, suddenly the ink get accumulated on the chalk. Okay, it won't take much time. Suddenly, within a fraction of a second, all the ink particles get adhered on the chalk surface. So this is because of the unbalanced or imbalanced surface force on the substances. ಓಕೆ ಚಾಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಅನ್ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಇಂಕ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರಾಪಿಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ವೆರಾಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ದ ಇಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಲೋ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಇಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಟೈನ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಇನ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್. ವೆರಾಸ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಅಟೈನ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಇನ್ ಅ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ಅದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೋ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದ ಇಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಟೈನ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್. ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬಲ್ಕ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದ ಇಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಅಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ಇಟ್. The examples, by that you can understand it clearly if you get confused between adsorption and absorption. Just these two examples are enough for adsorption and absorption. Okay, so whatever sentence is given in the first paragraph is nothing but that explains that adsorption is a surface phenomenon whereas absorption is a bulk phenomenon. I hope these two points are enough to show the difference between adsorption and absorption for 2 marks. And you can write the examples for this. So examples here, water vapor is absorbed. See the spelling here, absorbed. Okay, by the anhydrous calcium chloride. Whereas the silica gel is used as an adsorbent, and the water molecules are adsorbed by the silica gel. Okay, here water vapors with anhydrous calcium chloride is absorption. So this first point can be given example for this, and the second one can be given example for the adsorption process. Okay, yeah. And here also it is clearly explained diagrammatically. First one is absorption. You can see the blue particles are entered into the bulk of the solid substance, whereas here the adsorption, only the blue particles are adhered on the surface. They have not entered inside the ground colored ball. Okay. So this is the mechanism of adsorption. This says about the mechanism here. So what in terms of mechanism, yav riti navu mechanism anna illi helta idivi andre, see adsorption annod enide, since it is a surface phenomenon, it mainly arises due to the fact that the surface particles of the adsorbent possess unbalanced or residual attractive force. ಯಾಕೆ ಇದು ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಆ ಅನ್ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಥವಾ ರೆಸಿಡಿಯಲ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ಅದೇ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಗೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು ಮೇನ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಇದು. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್. and always surface mele yen molecule bandu kutkolutte, the particles are compactly arranged. So the compact agi adana hidkonbidutte, tight agi hidkolutte. So by that the movement will get stopped. A particles in a movement stop agutte. Iga illi nodi previous diagram alli you can just see here. Yeah, so in this diagram you can clearly understand. See this green color particles got attracted by this black color body, which is nothing but a charcoal. ಓಕೆ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬೆಂಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬೇಟ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಬಂದು ಈ ರೀತಿ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಅನ್ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸಿಡಿಯಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಓಕೆ ರೆಸಿಡಿಯಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ವಿಚ್ ದ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ And once they get attracted, there is a bond development between these particles, adsorbate and adsorbent. Ivere dr madhye yenagutte, a bond develop agutte. So due to which, the molecules develop the bond. And the molecular movement will be stopped. So avaga enagutte entropy illi decrease aguvantadu. Matte yavagadru na bond develop aagtide anta heluvaga, whenever there is a creation of the bond, always there is a release of energy. Hauda bond create aguvaga energy release agutte, bond break aglikke energy need irutte. So all this you have learned in thermodynamics chapter. So if a bond is developing or bond is creating between two particles, then it is an exothermic process, right? So whenever the bond is breaking, then it is an endothermic process. So since here the bond, whatever it may be, a physical interaction or chemical interaction, the bonds are going to be developed. So a bond develop padaga alli namige adsorption process so exothermic agirutte, the energy will be released out to the surrounding in the form of heat. Therefore the measure of this exothermic and endothermic can be done with the enthalpy, okay, change in enthalpy andre delta h anna navu symbolize martivi illi, okay, adana delta h anta heltivi. So this delta h for adsorption is always negative. ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಅದು ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೋಥರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಸೆಡ್, ವೆನ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಅಡಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ನೆಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ. ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೆಷರ್ ಆಫ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ನೆಸ್, ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಆಗಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ದ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬೆಂಟ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಫ್ರೀಲಿ. ಸೊ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಡ್ಹೇರ್ಡ್, ದ ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೆಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಎಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ, ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸಿಂಬಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲೆಟರ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಎಸ್, ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಹೆಚ್ ಹಾಗೂ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಎಸ್ ಎರಡೂ ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. Adsorption ಅಲ್ಲಿ delta H as well as delta S both will be negative for adsorption. And thermodynamic aspect of adsorption, okay, so by utilizing these information whatever we got from the mechanism, so we ಎರಡನ್ನು ನಾವು Gibbs free energy ಗೆ apply ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, see Gibbs equation which relates change in free energy, change in enthalpy as well as temperature and change in entropy all together in the same mathematical statement, delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. See, adsorption alli nan helide eradu kuda negative agirutte anta. So negative agittaga illi delta H kuda negative aadre, delta S ge negative sign anna substitute madidre it this becomes positive alva, eradu positive agutte, ondu delta S positive agutte, delta H negative agutte. So adre illi nodi first sentence here you can see adsorption is accompanied by a decrease in enthalpy and a decrease in entropy. That means delta H is negative, delta S is negative, as well as delta G is also negative. But according to this equation, as for the process of absorption, minus T delta S is positive. So when delta H becomes equal to T delta S, delta G should be zero. ಸೊ ಇದೆರಡು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಅನ್ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇದೆ, ಒಂದು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇದೆ ಒಂದು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಇದೆ, ಎರಡೂ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಜಿ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು, ಜೀರೋ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ಇದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಜೀರೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ವೆನ್ ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ. ಎರಡು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಬೋತ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಸೈಮಲ್ಟೇನಿಯಸ್ಲಿ. ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಡೇರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ಎಸ್ಕೇಪ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ನಡೆಯುವಾಗ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಡೈನಾಮಿಕ್ ಈಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಜಿ ಜೀರೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಹೆಚ್ ಹಾಗೂ ಟಿ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಎಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಡೈನಮಿಕ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೋಥರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೋಥರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಹೆಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಹಿಡಿದಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ಯು ಹೀಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆವಾಗ ಅದರ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೋಪಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಆನ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ the adsorbate and the adsorbent. That is physical adsorption, or it can also be called as physisorption. Here it is, physisorption. Or the chemical adsorption can also be called as chemisorption. Here it is, chemisorption. Okay? In physical adsorption, you can see it is also called as van der Waals adsorption because there is a weak force of attraction between adsorbate and adsorbent. When gas molecules or atoms are held to the surface of a solid by weak van der Waals forces, then it is called physical adsorption. Example, adsorption of dihydrogen on the surface of finely divided platinum, or just when I said ink on the chalk, that is also our humidity by the silica gel, all this comes under physical adsorption. Whereas chemical adsorption or chemisorption is defined as the phenomenon that occurs when gas molecules or atoms are held to the surface of a solid by chemical bonds. Here, there is a formation of chemical bond, and it may be involving an exchange of ions or electrons or sharing of electrons like ionic and covalent bond formation. Okay, so that happens, and the formation of a new product can be expected in the chemical adsorption. These are the definition with examples. And let us see the differences between physisorption and chemisorption. So this is very, very important for 3 marks. Compulsory question. Okay, you can refer the old question papers. So almost all question papers has this question. Weak van der Waals forces are present between adsorbent and adsorbate in the physisorption, whereas there is a chemical bond formation between adsorbent and adsorbate molecules. Depends on the nature of the gas. Easily liquefiable gases are adsorbed readily. Andre, example, nodi. We have a charcoal here. Okay, imagine we have a charcoal, and imagine hydrogen gas is there. Okay, I have helium and oxygen. So among these three, which has the higher molecular mass? So that is the question. Okay, so ee moorralli yavudakke higher molecular mass ide annodu question. So yavudakke easily liquefiable gas, so which has high molecular mass that can be easily liquefiable. So pressure enide inversely proportional with the molecular mass anta heltivu. Eshtu molecular mass jaasti irutho ashtu kadime pressure requirement irutte for the this one liquefaction. Okay, yeah, so easily liquefiable gases are adsorbed readily. So as I said, imagine if hydrogen and helium and oxygen are there. So among those three, hydrogen's molecular mass is 2. Okay, so that is 2. Whereas helium it is 4 and oxygen 32. So oxygen has the greater molecular mass than the other two, that is hydrogen and the helium. So therefore, oxygen will get adsorbed first, and then comes helium, and then the hydrogen. Okay, so based on the molecular mass, so first position goes to oxygen, second helium, and at last hydrogen will get adsorbed. So depends on the nature of the gas. Okay, so it depends which gas is there, easily liquefiable idre adu first adsorb agutte, then the lighter one anta. Whereas in chemical adsorption, it is much more specific and depends upon the nature of the both the adsorbate as well as adsorbent. Here, whatever adsorbent is there, it doesn't matter, but the adsorption takes place. It is not much specific, whereas chemisorption is highly specific. Heat of adsorption is small. Since it is involving weak force of attraction, the heat which is coming out from this process is less. So it is just 20 to 40 kilojoules per energy in terms of kilocalories. If we want to write it in kilojoules, it is just 20 to 40 kilojoules per moles of energy will be released from physisorption. Whereas from chemisorption, it is around 40 to 400 kilojoules of energy. Okay, 40 in the 400 kilojoules angle. Illi heat of adsorption is smaller. And it is reversible in nature. So when we heat this, just the amount of energy will be released and required, and the molecules get escaped from the adsorbent. Whereas this is irreversible because we can expect the new product, the reactants will not be there. So reactants vapas namige sigodilla. So hagagi yenagutte, adu irreversible agirutte. Whereas physisorption is reversible and chemisorption is irreversible. Physisorption forms, since it is non-specific and not that much specific, it get accumulated, all the types of molecules get accumulated on the surface of the adsorbent. It forms multi-molecular layer on the adsorbent. Whereas in the chemisorption, you can see only the unimolecular layer since it is specific. Physisorption occurs at low temperature, decreases with increase in temperature. Okay, only low temperature is required. When the heat is given, the process is going to be decreased. Here, chemisorption takes place at high temperature since it is involving a chemical bond. First increases when the temperature is given and then starts decreasing with the rise in temperature. So increase of pressure increases adsorption. High pressure is favorable both for chemisorption and physisorption. Decrease of pressure does not cause desorption. Okay, it is not causing the desorption in case if we decrease the pressure. And physisorption equilibrium is attained readily as it is reversible, whereas equilibrium attained very slowly and mostly not reversible in case of chemisorption. So these are the main differences between physisorption and chemisorption. Any three correctly you have to practice and you have to write it. Okay, thank you students. In the next class, we'll discuss more about the adsorption and its applications. Thank you.